Hi, this is Guthrie Govan here. For the next few minutes, I'll be talking you through the basics of sweet picking technique. This is a much feared area of technique, but I don't think it needs to be. After all, nearly every guitarist knows at least one sweeping lick. That one there. This introduces the basic concept of sweeping. With a lick like that, you've got the 14th fret of the G, and then 13th on the B, 12th on the E, and maybe that bluesy bend at the end, from the 15th fret up to an A. Now, the conventional way of picking that would be down, up, down, up. One day, some time ago, a lazy guitarist discovered that if you just do three downstrokes in a row, it feels like one downstroke. You're saving a lot of movement, and the upshot of that is you can play quicker. So, hopefully, we're all familiar with that general movement. I think an interesting thing to do from there is to try and make it more of an exercise, is to try and loop it so that the lick goes up and down. So you'd have that six-note pattern. Now, there's two ways you can tackle this from the picking perspective. One is the idea of trying to maintain three downstrokes in a row, because it's so easy. And the other way is slightly different. But let's look at the first way. What we do here is down, 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 up, and then pull off. So you're not actually picking that 12th fret on the E string. And then maybe a little upstroke there on the B, and bring your hand up so it's on top of the G string, ready to start those three downs in a row. So down, 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 up, pull off, up, down. The other way, and your hand might discover this as you try and speed that lick up, is it's actually more efficient not to do all three downstrokes in a row. If you start on an up, you could go up, down, down, up, down, up, up. And that way you get two mini sweeps, one going down from the B string to the E string, and another mini sweep going up from the B string to the G string. Which, as you can see, has the potential for a lot of speed. And if you look at how much movement that hand is actually getting up to, it's quite deceptive. Lots of notes come out, but your hands don't have to move very far. We like things like that. And OK, from there, I suppose the next step would be maybe to make that arpeggio a little bit bigger.